Still to come on Granada, the South Bank Show at 10:45. Now, Chris Tarrant.
Anyone who wears a tank top like that deserves a smack round the ear. That tale of Jumbo and Dumbo, which was recently voted Holland's favourite commercial of the year, demonstrates one major current marketing trend in world television. If you want to see your message clearly, animals in ads are not to be sniffed at. And it makes sense. Cuddly creatures will not only work for peanuts, literally, but they do seem to have the ability to communicate a whole range of complex messages far more eloquently than any human ever could.
We are looking for parakeets who love football, who enjoy the show, who feel our colors, who get excited, and above all, who want to fly with us. We are going to play football. Don't miss it. Español de Barcelona, the parakeets. Join the club. Call now.
Shoni, the Cola Evdel.
That's the one time a dog can be confident his owner won't throw a bucket of water over him. And animals can handle much more sensitive subjects. For example, during the very fragile run-up to the country's first ever free elections in 1993, a South African bank wanted to broadcast a national Christmas message of peace and goodwill.
Celebrating this Christmas, may all South Africans hold joy, hope, and peace in their hearts. A message of goodwill from Nedbank.
Now, meanwhile, in California, the county animal shelter relies on its rescued little creatures being cutesy and cuddly themselves to appeal to potential owners. Unfortunately, on this occasion, nobody mentioned that to Pinky the cat.
This is Pinky. He's a male cat, domestic short hair. He's available for adoption. He's pet of the week, Placer County Animal Shelter. He's a very loving cat.
Pinky.
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 Pinky. Pinky, settle down, bud. Oh, I get a catch cold. Somebody got a catch cold. Just set it over.
up all together?
Yeah, because I'm not going to do that.
Dude. I think it's cut up in there. Disconnected from the deck. You guys in the back?
Serves him right, Pinky there, with a seriously provoked outburst of really mad cat's disease. Now, Pinky would hardly qualify as a dumb animal, would he? Nor would the unmistakable star of the next clip from Mad TV, that's the television arm of the Mad magazine, who, for reasons known only to themselves, combined Free Willy with When Harry Met Sally.
A new story from Elfra E. Fran. A romance that transcends race, religion, and species.
Now, I'm telling you, men and whales cannot be friends, because no man can be friends with a whale he finds attractive.
So, you're saying men can be friends with whales they find unattractive?
No, you pretty much want to nail him too.
When Harry Met Willie. It's about love.
Believe me, I think I know when a whale is faking it.
Oh, really?
I'll have what the killer whale is having.
I hate that. You can't take a killer whale out for a quiet meal in a restaurant without them showing you up. Now, so far, even the Americans haven't given an animal its own TV talk show, although it's probably only a matter of time. But chat shows can be found in every TV schedule throughout the world. And some days and long nights in the USA, there seems to be a talk show on some channel or another all the time. The chat show's come a long way in 40 years. This pioneering CBS show was called Stand Up and Be Counted. Its stars were Bob Russell and, for the first time ever, the American public.
By listening to her story and voicing your frank and objective opinions, stand up and be counted.
Can you please tell us in your own words of your dilemma?
Well, a few years ago, my mother passed away, and just recently, my father passed away. And since I had lived a very limited life, going to work and coming home, right now I feel I should live a little before life passes me by completely.
Come up, ladies and gentlemen, up to this rail and tell this young woman what you would do in her situation. Let me ask this lady right over here.
I feel that she invested all her life for her parents and she's entitled to have her own happy life. And she should.
Thank you.
I think she's played for 20 years. She has to think of her security.
I think she's worked hard all these years, and she should take a trip to, and perhaps she may meet a man. She's unmarried. Yes, but don't forget, life is a gamble. You can lose money in business also. That money can be lost in business. Money isn't that important. And if she takes this trip...
Money, what is your life about money?
It's not the most important thing in the world.
Too many young girls today and too many women today feel that if they take trips, they're going to find romance. All they're going to find is somebody that's looking for a meal ticket.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
Note the barrier which kept the presenter at a safe distance from the audience. A device now sadly dispensed with. Now, the chat show recipe works like this. Take a fearless host, stir up an opinionated audience baying for blood, then mix in a generous helping of mind-boggling private admissions, indiscretions, and personal phobias.
Is there someone in the audience, anyone who would volunteer? You can pick out anyone you want. You tell us what you're going to do.
Why don't you take off your shirt?
All right, now explain. Let's explain what's going on here. Okay.
Well,
hey, how you doing, fella?
Pretty good,
So far, okay.
Yeah, so far, all right.
Now, you're a little cold.
Yeah, a little cold.
Okay, you'll warm up in a hurry. Now, what happened?
Well, now I'm gonna basically just massage him.
You can give a description of what you're doing while you're doing it. Hey, buddy, get your hands out of your pocket.
Massage.
Okay, now this differs from a normal massage. How?
It's different because it's more sexual.
Yeah.
And actually, if I wasn't here,
yes,
I could get a lot more intimate with this.
Sure. And we understand because this is television, you're going to keep your pants on and all that, but it does it feel good?
Feels all right. She gets to take the gloves off, though.
Oh, it's better if your gloves are off, but that's okay. Hey, how much did this cost you, huh? He says, I understand that there's something you want to tell him?
There is something I want to tell him.
What's that?
Well, I'm really a man.
It's those kind of shock tactics that the American chat shows are having to employ these days to stay just one jump ahead of all the other American chat shows. No subject is sacred in the savage battle for ratings, even to the point where a Jewish host like Jerry Springer, whose family fled to America from the Nazis in 1944, will invite onto his show a family of self-proclaimed bigots who brandish a chilling line in anti-Semitism. To say this next clip may shock some of you is not true. It will shock all of you.
I am Jewish. My daughter is Jewish. Are you saying to me that if given the chance, you would kill my daughter?
In a second.
How do you explain to me, and I'm going to be polite to you because of your age, and I figure that once in life, when you grow a little older, maybe you'll learn, but how do you go through life suggesting that you have the right to say to any human being that one, you will kill them, or two, that you sitting here are better than any other person?
The Holy Bible. In the Bible, it tells us that when Yahweh returns, that's what I call my God, he's going to mark every Jew and they shall be killed. John 8:44 states that they are from the devil's children.
Okay.
People are ignorant. They don't know what I'm talking about.
Are you threatening me on television? Are you threatening
me? How am I threatening you?
I'm asking you.
No, I would never threaten
you. You're not threatening me either.
I'm making you a promise.
It's a promise?
Okay. The Jews' end is coming, and yours too. You hook-nosed bastard.
Okay, you're off the show.
I'm off the show?
Yeah.
God tells us to hate the evil and love the good. I hate the evil. Yes. I hate you.
Yeah. Okay. It's okay. He's upset because I didn't invite him to my bar mitzvah. Okay.
Duty calls.
Move it!
See the car.
Almira.
GTI. Let's go.
Let's go. Cover me. Huh?
Go faster.
I'm doing nearly 30.
Naughty boy. Turn left.
Why?
Litter. Makes the car look good.
Times you call this? Sorry, Gov. Traffic was murder.
You never meet professionals.
Neither were they.
The election, Almira.
Tell me about it.
You and your home are unique. So Direct Line, tailor-make a home insurance policy just for you. We note the exact location of your home, the security arrangements, the age of the house, even the age of the owners. By taking into account things like these, in one short call, we can offer the precise cover you need without paying more than you want. Call Direct Line on 0161 839 8877.
Day after day, season after season, your hair loses elements essential to its natural protection. New Timotei, now enriched with plant milk, reinforces your hair's natural protection, leaving it radiating health and beauty. New Timotei with plant milk. Natural protection for beautiful hair.
Fresh mushrooms provide the source of light for every bowl of pasta. Fresh mushrooms light up a meal.
Right, well, I'll just order that for you.
This shipping agent makes 30 calls to America every week. So here's the good news. Oops, sorry.
Are you sure you're cut out for this, Rory?
Starting October the 8th, a five-minute weekday call to the USA and Canada, which used to cost £1.98, is cut by 25% to just £1.49.
Sam, now, where were we?
And with BT's business discounts, you can get it down to £1.09. Call 0800 800 800 for your savings checkup.
And in a living room tonight, a woman in a blue cardigan sminted her husband on the sofa. This practice is becoming...
Excuse me.
I'm sorry.
Ooh, sorry.
Excuse me.
I'm sorry. I can't let you do this. It just isn't natural. Nice and easy. 103. It works with your own tones and highlights, so the color looks totally natural. Let's rinse. And nice and easy. It's got pants and all for naturally soft hair.
For natural looking color that lasts and lasts.
Do you love it?
I do.
It's nice and easy to be natural. From Clairol.
Time can make Mark look this good. Imagine what we can do for a real woman.
I've been waiting.
And of course, Mark is now working as a masseur on the Jerry Springer chat show. Appearances can be deceptive these days. You're not even safe on a bus.
This is me, in Bali.
This is me, in Rio.
You can get away with anything in Rio.
And that particular Australian commercial highlights the down-under attitude to underwear, but actually contrasts rather starkly to the Danish view. See for yourself in this ad from Denmark's public access broadcaster, Stop. Probably so called because they don't know when to. This is supposedly a typical morning in a Copenhagen supermarket. This proud gentleman is apparently paranoid about ever being arrested for shoplifting, and he's proving that he has nothing hidden about his person. If there is anything hidden, the shop certainly won't want it back. I thought he was particularly brave standing quite so close to the waist-high freezer cabinet. One pack of frozen peas too high, and he could have been a shadow of his former self. But as you saw in Denmark, a completely naked man wandering about a supermarket gets nothing more than a raised eyebrow and possibly the occasional look of sympathy. Italians, however, approach TV shopping with far more Latin passion. See for yourself, the star of the Italian shopping network is Roberto da Crema.
Ricordatevi, Roberto, di irripetibile styling con televisore, perché, amici, in questo momento, con le 200.000 che avete a disposizione, io, attenzione, aprite le linee telefoniche, situazione irripetibile, diretta televisiva, io, in questo momento, venito a tutti e quattro, tutti e quattro. È pazzesco, dammi il coso! E allora come mai possiamo? Aldo, passi un attimo! Il mio amico camera, dammi qua! Faccio cadere tutti, allora!
Thank you, Roberto. I don't think I want one, whatever it was. Now, to be fair, not every sales pitch on the Italian shopping network is quite so aggressive. If a product is good enough, it will sell itself. It doesn't need a demonstration. But the Italians decided to demonstrate this one anyway. That vigorously vibrating shopping network commercial made a lot of Italian men very happy. They didn't ring up to order a massaggiatore massager, it just made them very happy. Meanwhile, in Brazil, they take to the task of selling labour-saving kitchen equipment with equal male enthusiasm.
Maria de Conceição, 2 years squeezing oranges for her sweetheart and her three kids. Silvio Araújo, ironing Dr. Araújo's shirts and suits for a year. Marley de Oliveira, 1 year mincing, dicing, and blending. Deborah Teixeira, daily cleaning the family's home and the beach house on the weekends. Christina Gias, using Singer home appliances for 2 years. Singer, for a good performance without hard work.
And with bodies like that, there isn't a wimpy man in the world who's ever going to tell them their place is in the kitchen. Next is a clip from the Australian talent show Potluck, where the artiste should have spent less time sewing sequins on his jockstrap and more time warming up.
Done it, have you? Oh, I think he's done a hamstring. There, you're out. Mate, well, I think we'll just take a commercial break, I think, and we'll be back after.
Fitness fanatics always say no pain, no gain. My personal view is no pain, no pain. We leave you with a clip from the Spanish show The Joke's on You, where an unsuspecting singer has to live up to the old showbiz motto, the show must go on. Night-night.
Quizá ya todo este dicho de la arena y del camino. De la arena y del camino, quizás ya todo este dicho de la arena y del camino, quizás ya todo este dicho de la arena y del camino. De la arena y del camino, del azul claro del cielo y del verde de los pinos, del azul claro del cielo. Y del verde de los pinos. el embrujo de las noches rocieras. De las noches rocieras. El embrujo de las noches rocieras. Ya se ha descrito el embrujo de las noches rocieras. De llanto, polvo y sudores, de curas rezando salve y sin pecado de colores, de curas rezando salve y sin pecado.
I locked up my den, the dogs and the...